In an attempt to ease the horrendous traffic in Metro Manila, one of government's solutions is the bus rapid transit system, which was recently approved by the National Economic and Development Authority, or NEDA. The BRT system uses long buses that function like a train. The cost of project, 38 billion pesos. It is expected to be operational by the year 2020. It will have stations along EDSA, Macapagal, Ross Boulevard, Ortigas BGC, and the Makati Business District.
Ito po yung nakikita natin na nag-work sa ibang bansa. At saka ito pong dedicated lane for buses. Ang ibig sabihin po nito, yung mga nakasakay sa bus, mas mabilis na makakarating. We would really like the car owners, no, na mag-migrate to public transport.
But commuters and transport groups doubt if the project can help solve traffic. Instead of declogging major thoroughfares, they believe the BRT system will just eat up more lanes. NEDA confirmed the project involves the construction of dedicated lanes with 63 stations or terminals. A study conducted by the Philippine Center for Public Transport shows the BRT can carry around 80 passengers at one time, while the MRT can carry 1,860 passengers. Another possible problem is its turnaround, which could create more traffic. The BRT needs 150 meters of space to turn back, compared to only 19 meters for the MRT to switch rails.
Noong i-test drive nila yan, tumukod ng 30 minutes ang mga traffic dahil yung palo niya, dahil pag ano niya, di ba, umaano, hindi kaya ng mga streets natin.
The MRT also has a longer lifespan and cheaper compared to the BRT. If the objective is to solve traffic, Medina believes the BRT is not an answer. Medina's group believes instead of spending 37 billion pesos on the BRT system, government can use the money to further improve the MRT and create other railways in the country.
The best solution all over the world, time-tested, safe, no pollution, is still the use of the train system.
Aside from the BRT system, NEDA has also approved funding for the construction of the Bicol International Airport and for the improvement of Dinaiya. Ron Gagalak, ABS-CBN News.